This is what I can tell you, and remember this well. You'll both surpass him altogether.
We've accepted the fact that we're not meant for each other. I just want to make sure that Lawrence will be all right.
Hello?
Orlando.
Ernesto, how was it? Have you talked to Camilo?
He's on his way home now.
He wouldn't listen to me, Orlando. He's still very upset with Lawrence.
I'm so worried. He still doesn't know that Shella ran away from home. Shella said she might know
where to find Lawrence.
So where on earth could those kids be?
I still don't know, Ernesto. She still hasn't called me back.
Orlando, as soon as you hear a word from Shella, let me know right away.
I have to know where they are.
Sure. I have to go. Camilo might be home soon.
Camilo, what should we do now?
Derek, didn't I tell you to keep a close eye on Shella?
Well, boss...
Camilo. Derek had no fault in all this.
You let her get away, didn't you?
I did.
So you're going against me now?
No, Camilo. I simply want to set things straight, since you're way out of line. Your mind has become so closed that you're incapable of listening to reason.
Orlando! Derek, go find Shella. I'm pretty sure that she went to go see Lawrence. And this time I want to get immediate results. If you fail, you're going to be in big trouble, you hear me?
Yes, boss.
I'm fine now. I'm all better now that you're here.
I really got so worried when I heard that you were wounded.
Sorry about that. You shouldn't have worried too much on my account. Shella? How did you know I was here? Even I don't have the slightest idea how I got here.
They found you lying unconscious along the road. I don't know, I just had this uncanny feeling that I'd find you here.
Thank you. You're my only strength now. Back in jail, I almost wanted to give up. Every time I think of you, it all just goes away. Even if I know that we're just friends now.
I just came over to make sure that you're safe from harm. And to convince you to come back with me to surrender.
Boss, I've already circulated photos of Lawrence to all the precincts in San Ildefonso. As well as the other precincts at the nearby town. But boss, not one of them has any clue where Lawrence could be hiding.
Then search more thoroughly, you useless morons! If you have to post this damn face in the papers in order to catch him, then do it!
All right, boss.
I'd be willing to hand out a reward to anyone who can tell us where that bastard has been hiding.
All right, boss. I'll do my best to make that happen.
Derek. I want to get results.
Legal? Cello, your uncle has already gained total control over the entire Monte Gracia. While I was still in prison, someone tried to kill me. I won't go back there.
Lawrence.
Hello? Cello?
Hello, Aunt Erlanda.
So how are you both doing? Were you able to find Lawrence?
I was. He's doing better now.
So when are you coming back here? Huh?
I really don't know yet.
Okay. But do be careful, both of you. And don't forget to keep me posted. Cello, you hear? So where are you right now?
We're right here at... I'm very sorry about this, Aunt Orlando, but I can't tell you where we are.
I'm afraid that Uncle Camilo might force it out from you. But don't worry, Aunt Orlando. We'll come back as soon as things get better.
Aunt Orlando, could you please tell Mother
Lupin not to worry? Not to worry too much about me.
Bye.
Aunt Orlando? I'm pretty sure that my father's also worried sick by now.
Don't worry, Lawrence. I'm sure Aunt Orlando will let him know that you're doing better now.
Cello? Could you stay with me for a while?
I'll be staying here until you get all better.
Thank you.
You've always encouraged them ever since, Orlando.
Camilo, I only wanted to make sure that they'll both be all right.
And so you simply allowed Cello to be with that fugitive, is that it?
Camilo, have you forgotten that Cello happens to be Frida's daughter? Don't tell me you're holding a grudge in her just because of that.
She's still a San Carlos, Orlando. Whoever her biological mother is, she'll always be my brother's daughter. And don't you try to twist things around. You of all people should know why I happen to dislike Lawrence. Not only because of his family, but also because he did try to kill me. That's the truth. The only truth I know, Orlando.
Frida, Camilo is never going to stop pursuing Lawrence.
Haven't I told you that in the first place?
Lawrence's life is in danger, especially now. I'm sure Camilo's already found out. that Shello ran away to look for Lawrence.
And how did you know about that?
Orlando told me about it.
Goodness, Ernesto, I can't believe you. How could you still keep on seeing that woman? Huh? Don't you realize by now that she's the cause of all our troubles? I can't imagine what Camilo would do if he finds out about that.
Orlando and I haven't done anything wrong, Frida.
Go tell that to Camilo.
Sang. Your daughter ran away from home again. I don't know what to do anymore. If only you were here.
There. The boss's bonus to you. He was obviously pleased with the way you convinced Orlando.
She comes here almost every day, and I'm getting really sick and tired. Oh, come on, Derek. Until when do I have to deal with her? It's getting to be so tiring. How am I getting bored?
Until forever. Don't worry, after all, you're getting well paid for it, right? But remember, Lydia, if you should ever make a single slip that will put the boss on a spot,
Sir Ma'am Lupe has arrived.
Camilo, did you want to talk to me?
Sit down, Lupe. I want to talk to you about Shello. I know you're the only one who can convince her to come back.
I don't even know where she is. How can I even talk to her?
There are ways, Lupe. Just leave that to me.
Orlando, here, have a drink.
Thank you. Lydia, please bear with me. I know that it must be bothering you.
It's all right. I understand.
You know, I'm going through a lot of things right now. So whenever I come over here, or to my daughter's grave, it's like I could almost feel her next to me, that she never left my side. It makes me feel better, and it gives me more strength to hold on.
Hi.
Frida, what are you doing here?
I just brought you something to eat.
I have someone to cook for me.
Oh, going somewhere? For crying out loud, Ernesto, our son's still missing.
I happen to know that Lawrence is doing just fine, which is why I'm no longer worried.
And I'm sure that it was Orlando who told you that he's fine, right?
Stop it, Frida. Don't give me that jealous wife act of yours.
Well, you know what? I am a jealous wife. And the last time I looked, we are still a married couple. Our marriage isn't annulled yet, so I have every right to be jealous.
But as far as I'm concerned, our marriage is long over. We're over. So do me a favor, Frida, deal with that fact. One more thing. Why on earth are you so concerned about Lawrence? And you don't show the slightest bit of concern about Shello. She's supposed to be your daughter too, right? Frida?
Have been saving love songs and lullabies, and there's so much more no one's ever heard before. Something's telling me.
Come on, let's run. Malik must be very tired.
That's your fault, you slave driver.
Sorry.
I think I have to go now. My mother might be looking for me. She's all alone at our place.
Okay, thank you so much, Malik. Come again tomorrow, okay?
Okay, I will.
Oh, wait. Here. Take this.
Thank you. Mother would be so grateful. You're such nice people.
All right. Go on now.
Take care of yourself.
Go straight home, you hear?
What is it?
Well, since your patient's all better now, and I'm pretty sure that they're all getting worried about you, it's okay if you decide to go home now.
Are you sure you don't want to come with me? Lawrence.
Cello. Forget it. I'd rather not. Even if I wanted to, I just couldn't go back there. I guess this is where I'm meant to be.
Until when will you keep on hiding? And just how sure are you that you'll be safe here?
No matter where I go now, trouble will always have a way of finding me. But at least right now, my pursuers won't find me here. No one here would report me to the cops or to your uncle. I'll be safe here, Shano. And besides, the natives treat me like I'm already part of their family.
I know what you mean.
There's so much food here. But someone here seems capable of eating them all.
So he eats a hot
feast tonight.
That's what I said, Shell. Wow, it's delicious. Hey, that's mine. That's my favorite dish. This one here has nice moves. I wonder if I could do that.
Go on, try it.
What are they doing, Oleg?
They're offering their thanks. This is their Thanksgiving feast for the God in heaven.
I knew it.
Salam alaikum.
That means
what?
It's time to eat. Come on.
Okay. This looks good. Thank you. We'll just share.
Shall I hope you can forget him? I hope you can learn to love a man who's more deserving of your attention. Lupe? Orlando.
You miss her, don't you?
Shallow's a good girl, you know. She always followed what Essing and I would tell her. But when it comes to Lawrence...
Lupe, I know how worried you must be about Shallow. But try to understand how she feels. She's all grown up. She has her own life to live. Let's not try to interfere with whatever she wants for herself. And besides, Shella's a smart girl. She knows what she's doing, Lupe. We'll just have to trust her on this.
And who are you to tell me that, Orlando?
I'm gonna have these bananas.
Thank you.
No!
What are you trying to say?
Oh, thank you.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you, Shella, for coming here. And don't you worry, we'll take good care of Lawrence here.
Thank you, Ulek. Mm-hmm. Oh, they're good.
Come and join what? Dance. Join dance.
He's inviting you. Come on.
Dance.
Come on.
Oh,
I teach you. Come on. Give it a
try.
Come on, Lawrence.
Come on.
Give it a try.
Go on. Come on.
What about you?
You go ahead.
Here. Oleg.
Go
join
on.
Dance.
I'm not good at
no,
this.
No, I teach. I teach.
Oh, my.
Come.
How does it go?
Here. Come join. Dance now.
Like this?
There. Like this.
Oh.
Like this. Yeah. That's good.
Are you sure?
Good. That's good.
Lawrence? Son. Are you really going to allow Shallow to leave? Isn't there any chance for you to get back together again? I don't really mean to meddle with your business. But I can see that both of you are still crazy about each other. She didn't come here simply because she only wants to help you out or to see that you're okay. I know that the reason why she's here is because she still has feelings for you. Love.
Well, Oleg, I really don't know what to say to that. And Besides, I'd rather not expect anything now. All I know right now, Shella would rather start a new life. She deserves to have a better life than be with me. I'd rather not get her involved in this trouble I got myself into. And besides, I've learned to accept the idea. I've accepted the fact that we're simply not meant to be together.
Who are you to be telling me what to do and how I should deal with my own daughter? I happen to be her mother. I brought her up myself, Orlando. So I ought to know her more than anybody else. And I should know if my daughter is being treated properly.
Lupe, that was not my intention.
She has a point, Orlando. You've become way too meddlesome when it comes to Shello.
Same goes for you, Frida. You know, ever since the both of you came into the picture, you've only succeeded in making Shallow's life more miserable.
I'm getting tired.
Dance,
better dance,
dance,
down.
Dance, dance, like this.
You're a pretty good dancer.
Really? It's quite tiring.
You're tired?
Mm-hmm. They're really great dancers.
But I still think you're better. They might step on that.
All right.
What?
Everyone sit down. Eat some. Eat.
What for?
Lawrence and Shello, with heaven as our witness, you are now both bound to love each other for the rest of your life.
Wait a minute. What do you mean by that?
Lawrence, you're now a married couple.
What?
After all, you're very much in love with each other, aren't you?
Well, they're right about that, Shadow. Until now, I feel the same way. And I don't think I can ever stop loving you.
Lawrence?
Lupe, do you have to get me involved in that? And besides, I have every right to be with Shello since I happen to be her real mother. Unlike some people around here, who are just trying to fit in.
Frida, you may have given birth to Shelo, but that's about as close to a mother as you can get. You're a worthless mother. You've done nothing but make her life miserable. Lawrence and Shelo would never think of running away in the first place if it hadn't been for you.
Why, you really have some nerve.
Stop it. To me, you're both the same. You've no right to make any claims on Shelo. You've no right.
Lupe? Lupe! 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 Russell! Help us! Lupe! 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 Oh, Russell, help us! Lupe!
I love you so much, Shelo. This ring I have. I never took this off my finger ever since you gave it to me.
Time, I've been passing time, watching dreams go by. All of my life, lying on the sand, watching seabirds fly.
We are going to make them understand that we love each other. Because this is the only memory I have left of your love. You and this ring you gave me have been my source of strength for me to be able to get past all the trials I have to face. I know and have accepted the fact that after everything that's happened, it probably wouldn't be right for you to have me back again, for you to love me again. But Shelo, I still can't deny how I feel for you. That you're still the only one I love.
Lawrence, it's my family who wants me to keep away from you. When my father, Essing, died, it had been so hard for me to deal with it. And that memory is still hurting me now. But even back then, I never blamed you for it. And wherever Father Essing may be right now, I'm sure that he's smiling down at us and giving us his blessing. because he should know by now how I truly feel. Lawrence, up to this very moment, my feelings for you has never changed. I love you so much. I don't think I can ever love anyone as much as I love you.
Watching trains go by. All of my life, lying on the sand, watching seabirds fly, wishing there could be someone waiting home for me. Something's telling me it might be you. All of my life, looking back as lovers go walking past. All of my life, wondering how they met.
Doctor, how's Lupe doing?
Well, her heart seems perfectly healthy to me.
Are you sure, Doctor? I heard that at first she was gasping for breath, then fainted all of a sudden. Like she had a heart attack.
How many times has this happened to her?
From what I know, Doctor, this is her first.
I see. Well, maybe it would be better if we can find her here for a few days, Governor, and so we could run more tests. Well, I'll have to leave you here. I have to go check on my other patients. Goodbye.
Thank
Goodbye.
You, Doctor.
Wait, I'll just call you back, okay? Uncle. So how was it? Any news about Lawrence?
None so far. I still haven't heard a word from Orlando.
I wonder how he's doing now.
You know, Jian, that's exactly what I'd like to know myself. So I keep thinking, or I lead myself to believe that your brother is in a safe place right now, wherever that may be.
That's what I've been doing too. I keep praying that he's all right.
Right now, that's about the best thing we can do for your brother.
Orlando, look, don't you feel sorry for Lupe? Why don't you give Shelo a call? Tell her about what happened to Lupe. You're the only one who knows how to reach her. Aren't you worried that Shello might end up blaming you later? If something should happen to Lupe and they never get to see each other again?
Well, I know they'll be very happy together, and I'm so happy for
them all. Right. All right.
Good night.
Goodbye.
Good night.
Bye.
Good night, everybody. Good luck.
Thank you very much.
May the heavens bless you.
Thank you.
Good night.
You.
Good night.
Bye.
Let's go now.
Take care.
Okay, thank you.
Good night. Bye.
Right, be careful.
Yes, we'll be careful.
We will.
I'd better be going too. Goodbye.
Thank you. Take care.
See you tomorrow.
I feel so happy right now.
Same here. You know when we're together like this? Whenever you're near me? All my troubles seem to disappear. I love you so much, Shella. Which is why I can't stand to see you waste your life like this.
Loris.
Isn't Lupe such a pitiful sight? But then... What else can Camilo expect from you, right? You wouldn't think of telling this to Shello. I know you, Orlando. You'd rather keep Camilo and Shello apart from each other. In that way, you can have all the San Carlos riches to yourself. Right?
How dare you say that, Frida? You better leave before I lose my temper.
You have no right to question my attachment towards Shello.
Look, you're her real mother, right? Why aren't you even looking for her? Why don't you even know where she is?
Because you don't even care about Frida.
Because ever since, you've never really cared for anyone else but yourself.
Go, I dare you.
Try it.
You better leave, Dada. Get out of here.